Hey, what's up, peeps? Welcome back to my channel. So today I'll be doing a little vlog for you. I just got off of work not too long ago and I got ready, came home and showered. I'm heading out to town because my friend Kawaii is in esthetician school and she was looking for a model for a microdermabrasion assessment. So I'm going to be going to the school tonight and getting a little facial. I've been wanting to get a facial done and treat myself because it's actually been a few years since I actually gone and had a professional facial done at a spa. This one is at the school and I never had a microdermabrasion type of facial done on my skin, so just for like my own records, and I wanted to see how much of a difference it's even gonna make, because these can get pricey. So I just figured why not share the experience with you guys as well, in case you guys were wondering how a microdermabrasion type of facial would be. And yeah, so figure why not just bring along you guys with me. I probably can't film while I'm getting the facial done because again, it's her school and she's doing an assessment on me. I'm just the model there. But I wanted to show you guys how my skin looks like bare, nothing on. I just washed it in the shower. So it's my skin. I have a little bit of dryness here. On the other side, it is about to be that time of the month, so my hormones are just like fluctuating and I'm breaking out a little, but I figured why not bring you guys along with me and we'll see how this facial goes. So I just got to town and I have no idea where I'm going. I parked at a Whole Foods, guys. So I made it in the elevator. It's literally across the street of Whole Foods, but I'm gonna go and check in and see how this goes. Alrighty guys, so I just got back. I'm in the car right now and I just got the facial. You can tell that I had work done. Like, you can kind of tell that my skin's a little, not irritated, but you can tell. It didn't hurt at all. But my skin feels really smooth. I shouldn't be touching it right now, but I'm tired, so I'm gonna go back home and I'll check in with you guys tomorrow. Hey guys, so it is the next day and I wanted to go ahead and update you guys on my skin and how it's looking like. I am in front of the same window and same natural daylight as it was yesterday when I showed you guys my before face. If you guys aren't familiar with my channel and who I am, I suffered really bad acne, cystic acne, back in the day, like when I was in high school, and I actually went to a dermatologist. I would honestly get steroid shots in my nose and like around my cheek area just to help with the cystic acne. My doctor at the time told me I could try Accutane. I tried Accutane, but that did not work well with my body. It was too strong for my body. I ended up throwing up, so I stopped doing that. And it actually took me a while to go on birth control. And honestly, that's been helping me with my acne, especially all over my face, because I honestly used to break out everywhere. I still break out along my jawline because that is hormonal. I do have PCOS and it's a hormonal imbalance. I do take vitamins to help balance my hormones, and being on birth control does help with that. But every now and then, especially during the time of the month, which is TMI right now, it's happening right now, that's when I do have breakouts. If you guys can tell along my neck, I am breaking out with my eczema because it's been very, very hot here on the island, so that's that. But I wanted to let you guys know the update of my skin and if I would ever get this type of facial done again. And the answer to that question is yes. I do want to book with my friend in about 2 weeks just to kind of have my skin heal up, just to monitor how it's going to be, because I do have dry combo skin, and this type of treatment that they did, they're basically kind of scraping away the first layer of dead skin and kind of drying out the skin. So that's why they want us to really moisturize, put SPF, hydrate, and kind of stay out of the sun. So I wanted to show you guys the after of it, getting the facial done. I'm in the same setup as I was yesterday. I'm just holding my camera in front of the mirror, in front of the window in my room, same time of the day. And this is me. I just washed my face and put moisturizer on. I don't know if you guys could tell, but a lot of my darkness and like dark spots from past acne did fade already along my jawline. And over here, I am breaking out because I am on my period and that's hormonal again. But I noticed a difference already. They don't want you to be touching your face because our hands are dirty. And you shouldn't be touching your face anyways like that because germs and COVID, right? But that's that. Again, like I said, I want to go ahead and book again another 2 weeks. And if you guys never got this facial done before, I'm going to let you guys know something. They do your ears. So they get up in there. They get up in these little crevices and they take out the dead skin. And like they just bzzz, and that area does tickle. And even in the behind of the ear, which I was not expecting. So I really liked it. I really enjoyed it. I would say if you guys are on the island of Oahu and want to hit up my friend Kawaii, I'll go ahead and leave her social media links down below so you guys could get a facial from her. She is taking clients up until March because after that she's going to be graduated from esthetician school. So go ahead and get your facials done by my friend Kawaii. And yeah, if you guys have any questions about the facial that I had done, I do plan on booking with her again for other types of treatments that they might offer at her school. So if you guys want me to vlog more of that too in the future, let me know in the comments down below. But if you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and go ahead and click on the subscribe button if you guys haven't yet already to be one of my cupcakes. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.